Christine became my kind of goddess in a way. Tall, plain woman in her 50s. And I longed to be a writer. And eventually, she had a friend here who'd got a house near Alborough at Thorpe Ness. This lady had bought this house for her sons to join the Albury Yacht Club. And then this terrible disaster happened. One of the boys was swimming and he was drowned. So eventually they said, why don't you go and live there to start to be a writer? And they gave me the keys. My brother drove me over. It was built about 1890, really. Christine loved the front of it because it had a kind of glass room which was all sealed, and you could see, the sea almost hit it. There's pebbles all around nearby. And I went in January. It was thinly snowing. And after about a week, I walked into Albury, which is a long way, I might say, blown about rather, to get some food. And on the way, I saw a little shuffly man coming along in a cap. And when I got back to the house, there was a page from a diary fixed under the door, because there wasn't a letterbox. And it said, which is in a book upstairs now, it said, dear Mr. Blythe, would you care to come and drink with us this evening? Yours sincerely, E.M. Forster. So I walked all the way back, and they were doing the index to a book called about Marianne Thornton, who was Forster's aunt, who'd left the money, which gave him freedom. And because I knew how to do indexing. So I spent the evening with these, he had another old Cambridge friend of his, they were in their 70s, they seemed ancient to me. I indexed the book very quickly, I suppose, but I was starving, I was longing for, I had nothing to eat at all, just a glass of sherry. And obviously, slight cause of excitement. Then I walked all the way home again. And then, he was in Benjamin Britten's house, who was abroad. And every time I went into Alborough, he appeared and carried the shopping. It's amazing, really. And that's how I started, really. I was writing a novel.